the best study on generative AI, real impact study done in 2025, just came out. And this may be the best AI study I have actually seen. It was done by our friends at Harvard Business School, at Wharton. And what they did was they worked with over 700 people from Procter and Gamble and just showed how generative AI and large language models really impact quality and speed of work in both teams and individuals, but fascinatingly for me as well, also the emotional impact on these folks as well. So this is amazing, but we're also going to talk about what this means for you and your organization. So we're going to get to recommendations and everything else, but this was the study. They really took a lot of time. Now, importantly, they did the study using ChatGPT 4 and 4.0. And I say that because this study was done several months ago. And guys, this is only getting more and more powerful. So let's dive into what all this actually said. First of all, big highlight, the findings find that AI replicates many of the benefits of human collaboration. This is wild. And if you are a user of ChatGPT and others, you probably maybe start to see this instinctively. So ChatGPT, look, for better or for worse, I'm not here to judge one way or the other, but it feels so human that sometimes it can actually be, sometimes people use it as like a therapist or anything else, but it really acts like something that takes the place of teammates and human collaboration. I'm not saying that's a good thing or a bad thing. I'm just saying that this is the mental impact on people. But in terms of a work setting, that can actually be extremely effective and powerful. But here's the thing, clearly, for those very same reasons, we have to weigh not only operational efficiencies, but also the emotional and social implications for workers. And it is critical that they measure it, because this is fundamental to how we are going to work and the future of work. This is not just about how many widgets we can make in an hour. Okay, let's dive right into the data. So teams using AI, this is what they found. Again, it's over 700 workers at Procter & Gamble. Teams using AI improved by 39%. Guys, that's not improving by 5% or 6%. 39%, that's colossal. Individuals using generative AI, ChatGPT, specifically 4 and 4.0, improved by 37%. The other strange thing was that teams not using AI only outperformed by 24%. Now, why is that strange? It's strange because we typically think of teams as just, you know, clearly an accelerator of quality and knowledge and everything else. But in this case, what we are finding is that, interestingly, with AI, individuals with AI can actually do extraordinary work even without teams. This is incredibly impactful for solopreneurs and entrepreneurs and things like that. But it's also important, and this is what I do a lot of my work at Stern at as well, is that a lot of times you can get a lot of work done just by yourself before taking it to the team. And then you use that team and the time with the team much more productively. So I think that's actually really critical. This is not just a study about AI. It's a study about how AI can replicate a lot of the benefits of working with a team, which is critical. Okay, so what do we mean by quality? For example, just one indicator of this, I thought this was just like really interesting to see at the top. Teams with AI were 3 times more likely to produce what they call top tier solutions, meaning solutions that ranked in the top 10%. So this is not just about spitting out more. This is not just about, oh, well, it created more, but what's the quality? This was the quality, as independently judged, the quality of the work just came out 3x more likely to come in the top 10. Unbelievably important for those naysayers that are saying like, well, it's just going to produce slop. It's not true, because especially when you are guiding this and augmenting what you know and how you work, this is not just like AI out of the box. Can you create AI? No, this is AI augmenting what you do. And when it does that, it means that the quality of work that you do is augmented and the quality of work of your team is augmented. Absolutely critical. So otherwise, it's not just about quality. This is also about efficiency. This is the other weird thing that I keep seeing, is that how can you speed something up and also make it better at the same time? But here we are, individuals using AI completed tasks 16.4% faster. Teams completed these tasks 12.7% faster. And remember the quality gains that we already saw this. Also, they also produced longer and more detailed solutions, which kind of makes sense because AI has incredible just stamina, but also can just create a tremendous amount, whereas humans tend to tire out and maybe don't include all those details in their solutions. I think that's absolutely critical. Implications for hiring are huge for all this. We have to think about what this means for HR professionals. Here's the thing. hiring less experienced employees using AI, right? They compared, they performed comparably to teams with experienced members. So what does that mean? It means that folks who are coming up, who are using AI really well, or if you are one of these people using AI really well, you can perform sort of at the level of your experienced teammates. So why does this matter? Well, it really, really matters because imagine how well those performance indicators could go up when you're working with somebody who actually has the domain expertise. So too often we are not training across our organization. We're just sort of saying, oh yeah, you should really use it. But guys, we have to take the people who know the most and train them on AI. It's absolutely critical. And here's the other really interesting point for me is the emotional benefits, right? AI users are showing higher levels of positive emotions and excitement and enthusiasm and energy and less anxiety and frustration. And here's the interesting thing too, working alone with AI almost like mimicked working a little bit with a team in terms of the emotional benefits and things like that. Why do we say that? Well, think about it. Like I work a lot with, healthcare, with lawyers, things like that. Nobody gets into those professions because they want to do paperwork. Right? What this does very specifically and really impactfully is it allows you to get rid of a lot of your busy work and just reduce the time spent on non-value add tasks and spending a lot more time on things that you want to do. And also, ChatGPT tools like this tend to be extremely empathetic and helpful and infinitely patient. That is a big deal. Do not discount that. Okay, weirdly, using AI, people who are using AI expected their work to not be as good, or they didn't expect it to be so good. That's the other thing. A lot of times we just don't understand the impact of our work with AI, and it is worth pointing out. So you figure that one out. To me, that's an absolute mystery. Anyway, this was an amazing study. Check it out. This is a thing I posted on LinkedIn just to sort of like give you a broader view of it. But most importantly, guys, what does this mean for you? What this means is that you have to train your entire organization. And it cannot just be like you give everybody Copilot or ChatGPT. It does not work any more than giving everybody a treadmill will allow you to cure heart disease in America. This is about a behavioral shift. So just the way that we do this at AI Mindset is that we train entire organizations at scale, starting with senior leadership, working with the entire organization through digital courses, et cetera. Of course, you can learn more at AI Mindset. But really, this is about you understand that these pieces of data actually are rooted in real phenomenal research done by these phenomenal researchers. And thanks to Procter and Gamble and thanks to HBS and thanks to Wharton for doing this. Guys, get your team trained up now. It will make a huge difference. Start now.